The greatest advances made in science, I believe, have all been based on serendipity. 30 years ago, Governor Perpich wondered whether or not there was some way to restore Minnesota lakes to their prior luster as fishing destinations. My lab was working on cancer viruses, and someone asked me whether or not I could help them with genetically engineering fish. And in the process, we found an element in fish that was resurrected to become a primary way of fighting cancer after a 14 million year genetic sleep. We call it Sleeping Beauty. I'm Perry Hackett, and this is the best Minnesota fishing story you've ever heard. At the beginning of the 21st century was the idea that it might be possible to reprogram a person's immune cells to be directed to attack and kill specific types of cancer. CAR T-cell therapies began using viruses to bring the DNA in. They were so efficacious that two therapies were approved by the FDA for the general population. The problem is that roughly only 10% of patients that would qualify for this therapy can actually get it. After we brought the Sleeping Beauty back to life, my colleague Scott McIver suggested that it could be used for non-viral gene therapy. Then Lawrence Cooper spent 10 years developing the Sleeping Beauty system to reprogram T cells. And that unlocked efficient human gene therapy that didn't involve viruses. No one had thought about that before we did it. The Sleeping Beauty transposon system has matched the results of the viral studies. And there are reasons to believe that Sleeping Beauty may be preferable not only for price and availability, but also for potential effects.
I think you can think of biotechnology in particular as sort of two approaches. You can either take the approach where you want to hoard the technology and own everything, or you can take an abundance mentality view that as you share it and it'll have a broader impact. The University of Minnesota with the Sleeping Beauty transposon took the view that the more people that used it, the greater the chance that it would have an impact in the world. And because of that, combination of a technology and a visionary, in this case Perry, really pushing that this could be something that could dramatically change a lot of people's lives. That origin led to a whole series of scientists, and they're coming to Minnesota for that. And that secondary wave is now generating Minnesota as the destination for genome engineering because there's a cluster of entrepreneurship expertise. Globally, Minnesota has the highest density of genome engineering companies in the world. What we've been doing, especially the last 20 years, is building our toolbox, building the ability to manipulate and alter DNA. The goal is to master the skills just like you can with a word processor and change the code. We're trying to get to the point where we can do that same thing with DNA so that we can be able to customize those therapies based on what your health need is. And as we get better and better at being able to do this kind of editing, we're better and better able to make these kinds of custom therapies. And so it opens up an entirely new concept in how you're going to treat health, all because of Sleeping Beauty and Perry's vision to share. It's very important.
Winston Churchill said that people go through life constantly stumbling over opportunities. When they do, they pick themselves up, dust themselves off, and go right along. But in science, every now and then you see something that's a little bit unexpected, or someone asks you a question and it can redirect your whole scientific career. So if you stumble over opportunity, don't get up too fast. Look down and see what you stumbled across, because there might be something really important there.